Every software application or product we develop has a life cycle to it. And the two famous life cycle approaches are waterfall model and the agile approach, which is an iterative approach. No matter which model you follow, it has all the following stages. The first stage is requirement analysis. This is where our business analyst or the TPO, the technical product owner, goes and talks to the client, end client, if we are developing a particular software for which we want to sell it for clients. And if it's a product, we sit in a room along with the architects and the developers, and we brainstorm for some cool ideas to develop a product. So the key role here is by the business analyst. Once the business analyst gathers the requirements, she comes back and she explains them to the development team as well as the testers. So it's her job to make sure we understand, we as developers understand, and also the QA team, the testing team, understands the requirement so that the testing team can parallelly write their test cases. So the testing team is not going to wait until we finish the development. They are going to start writing their test cases and be ready by the time we develop the product. Parallelly, the development team, the architects especially, can sit and do the high-level design and the low-level design for the product or application. The high-level design is for the end users as well as for the all the stakeholders like the managers, especially the management team, so that they can easily look at the high-level design and understand what the entire workflow and the deployment of the application is. And the low-level design is usually for the development team, where we go to the class level or object level or even method level. That's for the development team. Once we are done with the design phase, then we go move on to the development phase. You know what that means? We are going to build a project using a particular language and technology. Once the development is completed, we deliver it to testing. The testing team would have arrived with the test cases parallelly as we were doing development, and then they run their tests to make sure they find bugs or they make sure break the system even before it gets to a customer. Once the testing team is done with their work, then the deployment team comes in. Their job is to take the end product and deploy it on a machine from which the clients can access it. And there are different deployment models. We can have data centers where we as product sellers can deploy the application on our servers, or some clients like them to be installed on their servers. So it's up to the client and the company. Finally, the maintenance phase. This is where the support team comes into picture, the technical support. So once the product is with the client, if there are any technical issues with the product, any errors, there will be a ticket from the client, and the technical support team tries to address it first. And if they can't resolve that issue, or if it is a feature that was missed out, then it comes back to the analyst or to the dev team. We need to analyze it and either deliver it as a change request, and everybody gets involved in that to make a decision on how to fix that bug and provide it as a service pack or a bug fix. So that's about the life cycle. When we come to the waterfall approach, each of these phases are done for the entire product or for the application. So we'll do the requirement analysis. If we follow waterfall approach, we do the requirement analysis, or the business analyst does it for the entire product at once, and we are done. And similarly, the design and then the development. All the phases occur once, and the entire product is delivered at the end of it. One huge disadvantage there is we don't get instant feedback from the clients when we do waterfall approach. We'll have to wait for the entire product to be delivered and then get some kind of feedback. Secondly, the technologies we are using, the frameworks we are building, the UIs we might be developing can be outdated depending on the technology evolving, especially today with the rate at which the technologies are evolving and changing. If we follow the waterfall approach, we might develop a product. By the time we deliver it, it might be outdated and no customer might like it, or even no users might even use it. With the agile approach, we can overcome these limitations. In agile approach, we are going to take only a set of requirements, and an agile approach is nothing but it's a iterative model. We are going to do each of these phases a little bit. So we're going to take a little requirements, then do the design, development, testing, deliver it to the customer, get instant feedback, and if there is an evolving technology, then we can easily change our product as it evolves over time. So we get instant feedback. That's one big advantage of agile approach. There are different processes and methodologies in the agile approach. One way to do agile is Scrum. A famous way which the industry is moving towards is Scrum. In Scrum, we have sprint planning. So even before we start a product, we do a lot of planning where we come up with the entire backlog for the product. as much as possible. If not all the requirements, we gather many, as many requirements as we can. Then in each sprint, we call a 15-day or 3-week time or 1-month time as a sprint. And then in each sprint, we are going to take a few requirements from the backlog. We're going to design for those requirements, then develop those requirements, allow the QA team to test them, and then even deploy them to the end user if required. So if the product can be logically used by an end user, we can deploy it at the end of each sprint. So at the start of each sprint, we do sprint planning, where the business analyst, QA, and the developer sit together and see what items from the backlogs can be bought in. And then during the sprint, each day we have a stand-up meeting where everybody meets again, and we make sure there's a scrum master whose job is to make sure that everything is going smooth in that sprint, and the developers and QA will share what they did that day and what they're going to do tomorrow, and if there are any impediments or roadblocks that are blocking them from doing their work. And the scrum master will go and try to resolve those issues, and we help each other in doing that. And at the end of each sprint, which could be 15 days or 30 days, we do a retrospective meeting where we all sit together again and then discuss what went well in that sprint, what didn't go well, what can be improved in the future. This way, we get instant feedback at the end of every month, and we can improve as a team, and also as a product, we can use whatever is good going to the next few sprints. Although I explained that there are different roles in startups or in some companies, you might end up doing or playing a key role across these phases. And in some big companies, you will have a separate team involved in each of these phases. So to quickly summarize, SDLC stands for Software Development Lifecycle, and there are two famous approaches today, the Waterfall Approach and the Agile Approach. Most of the industry is moving towards the Agile Approach. Scrum is one of the methodology in the Agile Approach, and it gives us instant feedback instead of waiting till the entire end of the software development lifecycle, wherein we might have chances of our product completely being outdated.